take a respect of memorizing the Quran. It's such a virtuous deed, a wonderful act, and there is actually a bunch of ahadith in respect of the virtues and the excellences of memorizing the glorious Quran, no doubt in this respect. And I would love to see all our children memorizing the Quran. But in addition to that, I would like to say that memorizing the Quran isn't the ultimate goal. This is a goal. The ultimate goal lies in ayah number 29, Surah Sad. كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. That is the purpose for which Allah the Almighty revealed and sent down the Quran. ليدبروا آياته. It's a blessed book. It was sent down to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم so that his followers would ponder over its آيات. وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. And in order for people with understanding to take heed. So mere memorization is insufficient. We need fahm in order to reach tadabbur. And tadabbur leads to implementation of what is in the Quran. This ummah without fahm, tadabbur, and the implementation of what is in the Quran worth nothing. So, whether Arab or non-Arab, we all owe the Quran, studying the Quran and learning its meaning. And that's why a couple minutes earlier, Ali has said, Bismillah Pari and Amin Pari is insufficient. Okay, you have a long way to go. MashaAllah, every single time you recite an ayah of the Quran for each single letter, you get 10 good deeds. So this is an investment which never fails you. As long as you're memorizing, as long as you're revising, as long as you're reading, mashallah, you're earning a huge amount of reward. This is an investment which the entire ummah, Arab or non-Arab, should invest in it.